Hey guys, today I'm excited to show you how to boost your data analysis using the powerful combination of SQL and Python. In this tutorial, I will take a practical approach and guide you step by step on creating a database from scratch using SQLite and Python. We will then dive into the nitty-gritty of data analysis using SQL and Pandas. I will show you how to create impressive charts, and on top of it, we will generate a professional PDF sales report. Okay, so without further ado, let us get started. As we will be working with SQL in this tutorial, I will first need to set up a database. I will use SQLite, which is a lightweight and self-contained database that stores data in a single file. Python also natively supports SQLite, so we don't need to install any third-party packages. For our example, let's say you are the owner of an online store that sells various products to customers. To keep track of the sales made by your customers and gain insights that can help you make better business decisions, you could set up a database with three tables: sales, products, and customers. The sales table would contain information about each sale, such as the date of the sale, the customer who made the purchase, the product that was purchased, the quantity of the product, the unit price, and the total price. The columns customer ID and product ID refer to the tables customers and products, and they are called foreign keys. The products tables contains information about each product that the business sells, such as the product ID, product name, and the unit cost of each item. The product ID column is the primary key for this table, and, as previously mentioned, is used as a foreign key in the sales table. The customers table, on the other hand, contains information about each customer who has purchased from the business, including the customer ID, first name, last name, email address, and phone number. The customer ID column is the primary key for this table and is also used as a foreign key in the sales table. To create the database, I have made the following Python file. Firstly, I will import the required libraries: SQLite, random, and datetime. Next, I have to find the SQL commands for creating the tables. To create a table, you simply need to provide a name, followed by the columns and their respective data types. After that, I define SQL commands to insert sample data into the tables. This also requires creating example data for the products and customers. With all the preparation in place, I can now execute the SQL statements. To do this, I will connect to the database using a context manager. If the database doesn't exist, it will be created. Once we are connected, I will create the tables and insert the sample data. Finally, I will commit the changes. And that is all there is to it. Let me now execute the code. As I can see in the output terminal, the database has been created successfully. So when I minimize my text editor, I can see the database file. Now, to view the content of the database file, I will be using the following website. I will make sure to include the link to the website also in the description of the video. On the website, I will click on Open File and select the database we just created. Here we can now see the sales, products, and customers tables. If we look at the sales table, we can see some sample data with a total of 1000 records in the table. The product table displays the product ID, name, and unit cost. All customer-related information is stored in the customers table. Now that we have our database in place, let us move on to the fun part and analyze the data using SQL, Python, and Pandas. To do this, I have created the following Jupyter notebook. As a first step, let's install and import the dependencies. We will use Pandas to analyze the data, Plotly Express to create charts, Kaleido to export charts as images, and FPDF to generate the final PDF sales report. If you do not have these packages installed, you can remove the comments and run the first cell. In my case, I have already installed the packages, so I can directly import them. Additionally, I will also import datetime, pairflip, and SQLite. With that in place, let's define the file and folder paths and the chart style. Plotly has some pre-built chart styles. For a clean and professional chart design, I will choose the presentation template. However, feel free to check out the other styles as well. Next, I will define the file path to our database. The database file is located in the current directory of this Jupyter notebook. So that is why I'm first defining the path to the current directory. This line of code may seem convoluted, but I wanted to ensure that it will also work if you execute this line from a named Python file instead of a Jupyter notebook. Hence, I included an inline if statement. Later, when we are creating the charts and the final PDF report, I want to store them in an output folder. With pairflip, we can make the output folder if it doesn't already exist. So, when I run this cell, we will see that we now have an output directory. Okay, this was a lot of preparation, but now we are finally coming to the meat of this video. To kick things off, let us start calculating the total sales by month. For this, we first need to connect to our database. All we need to do is to pass the database file path into the connect method from SQLite. Once connected, we can write the SQL query to extract the relevant data. I will not explain each SQL query in full detail, as this would be beyond the scope of this tutorial. But in a nutshell, I'm just selecting the sales date and total sales from the sales table and grouping and ordering them by the date. To load the results of this query into a Pandas data frame, we can use pd.readsqlquery and pass in the query and our connection. Let us now print out the data frame to see what we've got. For each day, we have now summed up the sales. While it is possible to group the sales by month with SQL, I wanted to show you how to do it in Python. So, typically, before manipulating the data, I'm first checking the data types of the data frame. As we can see, even though I declared the sales date as a date in my database table, Pandas converted it by default into an object. This is not ideal if we want to manipulate the date further. Therefore, I will convert the sales date column into a datetime object. We can verify this by running the df.info method again. Alright, now that we've converted the column, let us set the sales date as the index. By doing so, we can now take full advantage of the frequency conversion of Pandas. In our example, we will compute the monthly total sales using the resample method. After executing the cell, we can see the new data frame that shows the total sales for each month. However, instead of the dates, I would like to display the month name. To do this, I will create a new column and get the month name from the index. When I execute this cell, the updated data frame looks like this. Now that we have the data in a suitable format, let's plot it in a chart using the Plotly Express library. Specifically, I will use a bar chart. The first parameter will be our data set, with the month names displayed on the x-axis and the total sales on the y-axis. We can also see here the template variable, which we defined at the top of the notebook. If we specify the text, Plotly will insert the actual sales numbers inside each bar. Additionally, we can customize the layout further by setting a chart and axis title, as well as a tick prefix. To show the plot, we can use fig.show. As I intend to use this chart in a PDF report later, I will also export it as an image. Besides the output path, we can also set the width, height, and scale. A higher value for the scale will result in a higher resolution image. Alright, let me run the cell to generate the chart. Since I have zoomed in on my Jupyter notebook, the bars may appear compressed. To get a better look at the image, I will navigate to my output folder. Okay, and here we have it. Overall, I think this bar chart looks pretty neat and professional. Okay, and with that, let us move on to the next analysis. This time, I want to sum up the total sales by product. For this, I have written the following SQL query, where I'm joining the product table on the sales table. And, as before, to bring it into a Pandas data frame, I'm using pd.readsqlquery. Let me print out the data frame to validate the result. Great, we now have the sales by product in the correct format. So, I can directly create the chart. The code is very similar to the previous chart, with only minor changes to the data frame name, column name for the x-axis, title, and output name for the image. Let me go ahead and also plot this chart. Alright, and with that in place, let us move on to the last example, where I will create a chart to display the top 10 customers by sales. In my SQL query, you will notice that I'm combining the first and last name of the customers table using the pipe symbols. Of course, you can also use the concatenate function in SQL for this. As I only want to display the top 10 customers, I limit the result after ordering the sales. After running the queries, we have our top 10 customers by sales. To visualize the data, I will, once again, use a bar chart. After rendering it, the plot will look like this. Now that we have gained valuable insights from our data and stored each chart as an image, I thought it would be cool to create a PDF report. And fortunately, making such a report is easy with the help of Python's vast array of libraries. For this task, I will be using the FPDF package. Let me quickly guide you through the code. First, I define the font color for the text. Next, I iterate over the output directory to obtain a list of all PNG files. Once I have this list, I initialize the FPDF object. This object allows us to easily construct our PDF page. I start by adding a new page and setting up the font. Following this, I construct the title using today's date, set the text color, and add this title to the top of the page using a cell. After that, I iterate over each chart file name and add those images to the PDF page. Once this is completed, I save the PDF file in our output directory. And that is all there is to it. While the execution might take some time, once completed, we will have a new PDF report, which looks like this. So whenever you run the Jupyter Notebook from top to bottom, Python will pull the data from the database, create the charts, and generate the PDF report for you. This whole process was just a simple example, but it showcases how you can leverage the power of SQL and Python to accelerate your workflows. As I mentioned in the video, you can also do most of the data wrangling directly in SQL. For instance, if you want to categorize customers based on their sales, you can use a case statement to group the result by the customers after merging the sales and customer tables. The resulting data frame will display customers falling into the high, medium, or low value bracket based on their sales. However, if you prefer using Pandas, you can leave out the case statement and the resulting data frame will look as follows. To segment the customers, you can use the Pandas cut method by defining the bins and labels. Once you have the new column, you can sort it by sales and the resulting data frame will be identical to the one before. Therefore, there are multiple ways to transform your data. Nonetheless, remember that it is important to filter the data in SQL as much as possible, so that you retrieve only the data that you require for your analysis. And lastly, make sure to close the connection to your database to free up resources and prevent potential issues. If you're not working in a Jupyter notebook, I suggest using a context manager to close the connection automatically. Here on the screen, you can see an example of using a context manager. Okay guys, and that is all I have for you today. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.